Thanks, Mike. Hey, got something really fun this half-hour. I'll play a video of Andrew McLean from an old, not too old, but an older Warren Miller film from our trip we do with Ice Axe Expeditions to Antarctica. Clear? Okay.
It's really the last frontier. This place is pristine and clean and just amazing. Antarctica, this place just blows me away. It's my dream to bring my friends here and to ski and snowboard.
Finding a line and picking it and skiing it. And, there's a very good chance that it's never been skied.
Go. And in the studio, my very good friend Andrew McLean. Thanks for coming on the show with me, man.
Glad to be here, Todd. Beautiful corner studio.
Yeah.
Sun never sets in California.
Never sets. The sun does set on the morning show. You were in town for the California Avalanche Workshop yesterday. Thanks for coming. That was great.
Yeah,
it was good.
Any excuse,
I know. And that really, it really is funny. That was what we did. I was like, trying to put together a speaker. I'm like, Andrew, come do this speaking engagement, and then we can hang out in Tahoe. But yeah, thanks for coming. It's great.
Yeah.
I just saw that maybe you wrote the book, The Steep Skiing for the Wasatch.
Yeah, the shooting gallery. The shutting gallery, as some people call it.
and isn't that, didn't you just like sell out of all the books? Like you're kind of having to re-up it?
Yeah. When I first published it, it's self-published. I thought I was just going to burn them all, but people actually buy them, which surprises me.
Yeah, and they're still like, I mean, I've been to your house, like it's like every week you're shipping out more of those books.
Yeah, it seems to be having a resurgence. Mm-hmm. I published it 20 years ago and it's still cranking away.
Yeah, it seems like I just noticed here recently in the last couple of weeks, Caroline
Gleick
had just skied all of the lines that were in that book, and mm-hmm. there was like even a film about it. That was a big deal.
Yeah, it was really well done. Follow through.
Did you ski all of them?
Mm-hmm.
You did. You skied every one of them as well. You were the first one to ski all of them. You got any?
Funny how that works.
You got any? I mean, you and I are getting ready to go back with Ice Axe Expeditions back down to Antarctica. I mean, don't you find it so hard to like? I mean, I'm always here on the show saying, look, if we show video of it. I'm like, if you want to go to Antarctica, Facebook me, call me, do whatever, trying to get people. It's hard to communicate how cool that trip is.
Yeah, I think of all the trips I've been on, it's number one trip.
Yeah.
You know, it's just incredible. I'd go back year after year after year.
I know.
It's just, you go there for the skiing, but it's really so much more than the skiing. It's just an incredible experience, and the people and the environment, and skiing with penguins and orca. It's just.
Yeah, I call it the best ski trip in the world because, I mean, you and I both haven't done expeditions around the world. You know, you're in a tent with stinky guys farting and burping and dirty socks. I mean, really, that's the reality of an expedition.
Eating cold food.
Yeah, eating cold, crappy food. And here we are on this this boat with just what feels to be like decadence. You know, you've got a warm bed, hot meals, and then the presentations every evening, every day.
Yeah, it's a great trip. You know, a lot of local connection, obviously Doug Staup with Ice Axe, but you know, people, a lot of the locals here, Glenn Polson, John Morrison, Tom Day, Todd Offenbacher.
Yeah, you guys want to go to Antarctica, we got a couple of spots open to go down there. I think we leave on, the boat sails on the 29th of October?
That's a week earlier this year.
Yeah, so, which is always good.
That's good, yeah. So it's the first trip of the year.
Yeah, and that's what's cool too is, you know, boats go down there, people go down there to see the penguins and the icebergs and that sort of stuff as sightseers, but we at Ice Axe take the ship and it's all skiers that go down there to ski. It's about the same price, but we go before the other boats are there, so there's just no one else.
There's nobody there.
It's pretty
tons
cool.
Tons of wildlife. It's like skiing in a zoo.
Yeah, it is too. Yeah, because the thing that people don't realize until you go there, there's no land predators. So everything on land, you know, the birds, the penguins, everything, the polar bears, nobody, you know, I mean, they're not afraid of you.
Yeah. It's fun to see your first penguin.
Yeah.
And when you're with a group of people who's never seen them before, and you might go to one landing site and there'll be one penguin and they get to go nuts and you're like, pace yourself.
Yeah.
Pace yourself. And then you go to where there's a whole colony and there's, you know, 5,000, 10,000 penguins and crab eater seals, and you're skiing and the sun's out and you're just like, wow, this is an incredible place.
The other one I think is amazing in terms of wildlife sighting is being up on a mountain with the ocean below you and when there's whales. So you're actually getting an aerial view looking down at whales. We can see them under the water. Obviously, you see them when they surface. It's spectacular.
Yeah, we're seeing the penguins from the zodiacs.
Mm-hmm.
It's really cool.
You got any other trips you're doing this year? You got any?
I can't say on TV where I'm going.
Really? You're plotting it?
No, I like going up to Alaska in the spring. I was talking with Glenn Polson the other day, just yesterday, about some potential trips.
Mm-hmm. And you've done a lot of skiing up there, huh?
Yeah. So I like to do this trip, Antarctica, in the beginning of the season, then ski around the Wasatch during the main winter, and then go on a trip in the spring.
Yeah.
You know, when conditions, days are longer.
Sure.
And, yeah.
We just showed that clip from Wintervention, the Warren Miller film. The film Steep that you were in, who was that? Who produced that one?
It was started out kind of as a documentary. And then it was picked up later by Sony.
Right, so it was a big production outside of like what we think of in typical ski films.
Theatrical release.
Right.
Yeah.
The thing that was so cool about that is to me anyway was you ended up getting interviewed on the Stephen Colbert Show.
It's a lot like this, very similar. He doesn't have as nice a studio and he doesn't have a beer sponsor. But it was similar. Yeah.
That's pretty good.
It wasn't quite as quick.
All right. Hey, thanks for coming on the show, my good friend Andrew McLean. If you get a chance, go to straightshooter.com. And you've got some really good tips about backcountry skiing, ski mountaineering called Just
the Tip.
The Tip. We'll be back with your 7-day forecast. Stay with us.